Is that you, Alison?
Yes, that's me. I'm just getting started and recording, and I'll just jump into live on Facebook. So you guys just, you do what you do.
Perfect. Okay. You let me know and give me the countdown, like the 3, 2, 1, then the clapperboard thing, yeah?
Well, that's, I don't have a clappy board, but I'll do my best.
Oh, whatever. Okay, folks, very warm welcome this evening to the Lads Call. This is the monthly Lads Call. I'm delighted this evening to have Richie Barnett from New Zealand on. He is and I'm respectful of everybody's time, including Richie. So we're going to kick in and we're going to give it 30 minutes. And I've got a number of questions for Richie. But I do want to actually introduce you formally, Richie, because I'm not sure people have the gist of who you are. So if you don't mind, I'll spend a minute just running through bits and pieces. Sure. Richie Barnett, you're a former professional rugby league footballer in the 90s. That's the 1990s, by the way, in the 2000s. You are a New Zealand Rugby League representative. You've played 27 tests for your country. You captained New Zealand on 10 occasions during your career. That must have been a frightening feeling for you. That must have been just an awesome time.
It certainly was. It really was.
Brilliant. Good man. And you've played for clubs in New Zealand, Australia and England. You are still very much involved in the sporting community. You're a commentator on Sky Sport, I assume, New Zealand. You commentate the NRL over here?
Yeah, we do. We do mainly for Sky Sports, we cover the Warriors. So most of the Warriors games, all the Warriors games, we commentate and we either take the feed from Australia.
Yeah, okay, very good. And something else I've realised, of course, you're recently on NZ Survivor. Now, is there any secrets you can share here just between us, Habitos and Lads? Because, you know, we're always curious how these things work out. Any scandal that we can promote?
I tell you what, it is actually very true to what they either portray who you are, and obviously some will be portrayed in a different way.
Yeah.
But I think they got me right because I'm pretty straight down the middle. I am black and white. But the show was just extraordinary. I mean, I loved the whole competition. I loved interacting with different people and working in different environments. But it was like going to school and jam packing a whole year into a month.
Right.
And everyone was trying to prove their identity, who they are. And it was just fascinating. It's just fascinating.
Right. I'll talk to you about that later on, Rishi, before we get something out of you. And and also, are you an ex-rugby league selector for the New Zealand team?
Yeah, I'm not active in terms of doing anything for the New Zealand rugby. I was a selector for about 5 years with the New Zealand rugby league.
Yeah.
So I would either follow it or be a commentator for the internationals as well, but that's as close as I'll get it.
Yeah.
But I do actively sort of, if anything pops up and they need me to be there, then I'll definitely promote or brand aware that the rugby league here in New Zealand.
Yeah. But very good. And I can see from your website, you're a busy lad. You do a huge amount of work. And we are, as I say, delighted to have you on board this evening. You are on board this evening, of course, because of your involvement in Juice Plus. And we are delighted to have you. Just about your life off the field, Richie, what does that involve now in terms of your workload, how you obviously it was commentating, your foundations that you run? Just give us a brief insight into who Richie Barnett on a day-to-day basis is.
Sure. So some of it revolves around pathwaying youth into employment. So, and then I pretty much help them, guide them along a 30-month plan after their transition from school to work. I'm also involved in another charity which looks after children who have lost a parent. And that's been going for the last sort of 4 years, the non-profit organization and charity.
Yeah.
Very, very close to my heart. And I'm also an NL practitioner and a life coach. So I sort of work with people who have got high needs. So I work with some organizations here in New Zealand that are high needs. I also work with a range of different people, from youth to adults, different backgrounds, professional, or just people who are struggling to deal with, I guess, stress response to life in general. And I work with an organisation called Gumboot Friday, which is an organisation that looks after people who, and I'm a service provider for them, looking after people that are, who are dealing with suicidal thoughts. And obviously Juice Plus is part of the combination and the vehicle to support people with their health and wellbeing.
Yeah. Okay, you clearly are a very, very busy man. And the old saying is, give a busy person something to do, it'll get done. I think you fit that role beautifully. Can I ask you, Richie, what attracted you to the Juice Plus community? I mean, it's a broad-based question between products and community and those sort of things. What attracted you to the whole thing?
I was in a Tony Robbins course and I met Greg Whelan, and really the attraction was firstly to do with the products. A lot of people don't know, but I live with chronic fatigue for 12 years. So I understand what health and how health is so important to me. It's not until you lose it that you understand it more than anything. So I was attracted to it. I wasn't a product taker generally across my sporting environment and life, but I always tried to eat whole foods. But I was super impressed with it when I saw it. It made complete sense to me. If I wanted to bolster, I guess, my immune system, which is pretty much what most illnesses stem from, well, then I knew this was a no-brainer for me. And it's definitely supported me in the last 3 or 4 years that I've taken it. It has certainly helped me in a big way. It's supported me in terms of nourishing my body, my immune system. Yeah. But it's also supported me as well in terms of getting better at what I should be doing. And I've noticed quite a big difference in the last 4 or 5 years, so I'm grateful for that.
And you would have come through that regime, I guess, in your sporting career. So it's really just transcended out to your modern life now.
Yeah, it has. And what I was intrigued in, and I'm not a big product fan, but what I was intrigued of the Juice Plus model is that they are just so close to the real thing.
Yeah,
I'm all about trying to nourish my body with the best possible nutrition. And when I saw what this was all about and where the products came from third generation farms and what they didn't put in it, I was super fascinated by it. And it really drew to me because of the values that I hold in terms of nutrition and well-being and wellness.
Okay. Richie, I think you've encapsulated it well there, but in terms of your opinions around our option of living better, how do you live well? How do you eat well? How do you supplement well? That's clearly important to you, and that's the message that you spread around your surrounding communities.
Yes. Yeah, it's hugely important to me when I look at my life and I look at how people effectively eat and you look at what they're eating and how they react to certain things in life. And I deal with a lot of people who have got poor nutrition and it has a major effect on their overall health and well-being. So that to me is the foundation to anything we do in life, you know, us to be able to operate working 9 hours a day. I think in today's world, Mick, it's such a complicated world now. We're wearing so many hats now. The stress response mode to a lot of things now is heightened more so.
Yes.
We're trying to be community members. We're trying to be a husband, a wife. We're trying to be friends.
Yes.
We're trying to be, if you're religious, being a religious in the religious community. So we're wearing so many hats and we forget that we have to put the oxygen mask on ourselves more often. And nutrition is foundational to me. And obviously that mindfulness and so we're curbing the response to being reactive as opposed to proactive in life. And I think that's vitally important. I know there's a few studies out now from a clinical psychologist here in New Zealand who's been doing it for 10 years, who's based micronutrition as the savior to mental health and wellbeing, to ADHD, ADD, depression and anxiety. The studies have been phenomenal. They've used it here in the earthquake in New Zealand as well.
Yes.
They did it in a study in the earthquakes in Canada as well.
Okay. And
it is absolutely compelling evidence that we're getting. So, you know, it just gives me more faith that what we're doing. And what I'm doing is, you know, I don't really need to have science, but to be honest, it helps to have science.
Absolutely, it does, Richie. I mean, it's the, we've got now so many studies around our product, and you know, it's second to none. And you notice, and everybody that's on the screen who's dealt with us will know that as well. So, so you've enjoyed our products, you've enjoyed the programs, and you decided to join as an ambassador for our program and start your own franchise within Juice Plus. What was the attraction around that?
I've worked in construction as a business owner. I've worked in seafood retailing.
Yeah.
I've worked in owning my franchise system. So I get what it's like to work in a traditional model or in a franchise system.
Yeah.
What attracted to me more than a lot of things actually was it tapped into most of the values that I do hold. You know, health and well-being is very important. A sustainable model is pretty important now that we've seen life is getting so difficult and the hamster wheel is real.
Yeah.
I love the model because the investment was very small.
Yeah.
The overheads were ridiculously low, which gave me an entry point to have a look. Now, I've started a franchise system where I spent $200,000.
Yes.
And it required
typical, Richie, really, isn't it?
It is very typical.
Yeah.
And it is very typical that you end up spending a lot of your resource, your time, to run a business, and you're there from the beginning and you're there to the end. You are stressed at times because of meeting demands of wages, dealing with a lot of stock that's perishable. Yeah. And also dealing with GST and the like. So it just keeps going. And so I like this model, and it drew me in quite easily.
Yeah. Well, I'm delighted to say, Richard, that the business itself take care of all those headaches in terms of warehousing and stocking and sending and all the rest of it. So you're light years ahead in that sort of regard. I just want to get a couple of minutes from me on community, what the Juice Plus community means to you, how then it then filters into your circle of your other areas that you're involved in.
Yeah, the community to me, I've been in a lot of cultures and a lot of organizations, and what really resonated with me is they live the mission. I truly think Juice Plus is a company that lives the mission. Drives performance within individuals. So self-development is high on their agenda, which I love. I think the community in a wide space, I think their leadership program is exceptional.
Yeah.
Exceptional. And if you go lower in terms of people that we connect with on a daily basis, it is mind-blowing how uplifting it is.
Yeah.
It gives me such satisfaction seeing people that I've dealt with, seeing where they've come from and where they are now. It just blows me away that it inspires me as a person from coming from many different backgrounds and from my professionalism profession.
Yeah.
Just seeing people being uplifted, inspired, love it. And it's just ripping through this company and this organization.
But and you've articulated it well again, Richie. I mean, the community within the organization is phenomenal, particularly over the last couple of years when, as you've articulated before, has been very difficult couple of years. And that sort of community, that touch point, that personal interaction with people has been really critical the last couple of years. So you've done very well on that. I want to take you back again to, you're clearly all about contribution as well. And from your perspective, you got contribution an awful lot. Just take me through some of your organizations that you work with. Just give me a couple of minutes around all of them, please.
Yeah, sure. So, I know that, Mick, that we've had some support with Nutrition Plus, the charity that obviously Juice Plus, and that's provided us with some nutrition that kids in this country are suffering from. It is a pandemic in this country. I think it's globally as well, but in this country, I went to a school once and 92% of the children had one meal a day.
Yeah.
And Juice Plus provided some opportunities there. And again, the organization Nutrition Plus has provided us with some again, some products and support, financial support to assist us to assist the kids that are suffering in terms of health and well-being. So that to me is such a massive thing for me to be able to, for an organization to give, to support and contribute in a way for us to be able to deliver more and impact more people in our community. So the impact for me is all about trying to impact youth in this country in a way which can be as simple as just putting food and giving some nutrients for these kids, because we know how important that is.
So, yeah. Oh, look, and that's great. Nutrition Plus do a great amount of work in New Zealand. We also work with a lot of other organisations where we can support. And I know certainly Chair, you'll see there, has been the forefront of that, and obviously you as well, Richie. So anytime we can help, we absolutely will help where we can, and we're constantly looking for ambassadors that we can connect with, that we can then support where we need to support. It's an open-ended question here, but your market, are you just looking to help anybody? Have you got a particular genre of people that you're looking to support with the product and with community work, Richie?
Yeah, I think predominantly, I think it's the high needs and the stats that we sort of try to support. So predominantly, it's Māori and Pacific in this country.
Yeah.
They fall, unfortunately, in the stats in this country because of low income, because of the housing issues that we have in this country. A lot of it's positioned around a lot of individuals in a household, which creates a lot of issues in itself.
Yeah.
So that's our target market, but we'll help anyone that needs support. But generally, predominantly, it's Māori and Pacific in this country.
Yeah. Just when you came on board as an ambassador, and you would have seen how we operate as a business in the network marketing industry, what were your thoughts of that initially? Did you go, oh my God, no? Or was it you embraced it, you understood it, you took it on board, just got on with it?
Yeah, and it's a good point there, Mick. I think I was not au fait with how it worked. I've never heard of it before, to be honest.
Yeah.
And when I sort of started to think about it, it's very similar to a franchising system. So it sort of resonated with me more and more.
Yeah.
It's direct marketing. It is encouraging and impacting more across the globe. It resonated me when I was able to frame it a bit differently.
But I
get the model. It's a wonderful model that works extremely well. And there's no other person, I think. And what I love about it is that until you start building belief around it, that you start to really flourish, in terms of understanding, and this model in partnership with the company, it has built a belief in me that this is exactly the right organization that I'm working with. I'm grateful for that. There's no other organization I think I'd be able to work with, because I'm absolutely thoroughly have a belief in this company and how, I guess, the hierarchy, yourself, Celine, all our leadership partners in this group has shown that they truly are exactly what they are.
Yeah, and well, you know, what you see is what you get, Richie. And that's good and bad, but I mean, it is what it is in that regard. Just on that, if you had somebody, lads in particular, who are looking at this, and they might be feeling nervous around any stigma, for want of a better term, what sort of advice, like quick advice, would you give them at the minute, just to get them over that?
Yeah, I think like most things that I've always done, talk to people who actually have done it and succeeded.
Yeah.
A lot of people actually ask questions to people who've never done it before or have had a bad experience. We've all had bad experiences with certain things, but it doesn't determine who you are, doesn't determine having another go. But what I do ask people is to, if you know someone who's done extremely well, go and talk to that person. He has done everything in this business for you to learn what you should be learning from it. Those are the people you should be talking to, not the people that think they know or may have heard about it.
Yes.
So always go to the person that's done it before. And from my angle, there's no better company and support that would help and guide you through it than this company.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah. Where to from here within Juice Plus? You're in the business a couple of years now, I think. Richie, just refresh my memory, please.
Yeah, I think it's 2 or 3 years. What I love about it is that it's given me an option and an opportunity actually to actually take control of my life, being in organizations or operations where things can move quite differently and change. In construction and seafood, it can be quite buoyant. It can have issues if the government changes their policy. There is issues around it. But what I've found in this organization is that you can take your time and give the time that you need when you want, how you want, and to whom you want to work with, which I love.
Yeah.
This is open up more of an opportunity because I want this to be my main source of income. For that to be the case, it allows me to do more impact work in the communities. So I can show up and have the flexibility to work around the Juice Plus organization because it provides you with that flexibility of time.
Yeah.
And you can work anywhere in the world, which I really love as well, but it just gives you that flexibility of time to work and impact more people.
That's brilliant. That's I like that. The flexibility is a very important reason that we get people into the business, and that works really well. Obviously, we have our conference coming up in July in Canberra, and I'm not sure if you can make it across or not. Certainly, everybody's welcome to it. From your point of view, with your experience in your foundations and everything else, how important is it that people attend conferences or trainings or days, in that area of learning? How important is it for people to get around those sort of days?
I think it's really important to meet the people that have done it before and experience what they're like firsthand. Yeah. And they're so approachable, I guess, in this business. And when you go to conference, and I've only been to the one in New Zealand, I look forward to this one in Canberra because it inspires you from the people who have been there for 5 to 7 years, what they're doing. And it encourages you to grow, and it inspires you to want more. And being around the people that we've sort of spoken to and been around for the last 3 or 4 years,
yeah,
I want to touch base with them. I want to be a part of this community, and I want to be closer and feel it and see it from my eyes and then take it back to New Zealand and say how important it is. And we need to reach. Conferences are so important. I want to be a part of it.
Brilliant. And that's interesting you say that. And I know from my own experience there, important to get to. And I'll give you a very quick 60-second story. Our 3PL in Auckland, we invited them across to our Gold Coast conference a couple of years ago. And so we want to impress upon them the importance of our business and that they should treat our business with the respect that it deserves because it was a big business. And they were staggered. I think we had about 1,800 there. They were staggered of seeing the people and the energy and everything else. And then from then on in, they have been phenomenal to us. And not that they weren't before, but it just adds an extra layer of credibility, an extra layer of importance, an extra layer of let's get this thing done right the first time because the clients are good. So it's important all around, I think, that conferences are there. Before you go, young Richie, if there was a couple of young lads or mature age lads looking at this and they were sort of sitting on the fence, they weren't sure, what pearls of wisdom would you give them now to send them on their way today once we finish this call in a minute or two?
I think for most people, I think some people are unhappy in what they're doing. And unless you change, nothing changes. And to dip your toes to have a look and ask questions is the first thing I think I'd ask people to, if they're curious around what we do in this business. If health and wellness and flexibility and connection and contribution is high on your list, And if that's high on your list, then this may be an opportunity for you to take a look. Talk to the people that are involved. Talk to me if you want to have a discussion around. I'll be pretty straight up and down about it.
Yeah.
And you will get that from people in this business. We're certainly not ones to change the dial and prove that this is the best thing since sliced bread. But what we can say is that we'll give you the information and the evidence that support your choice, because it ultimately is your choice. But what I can say from my eyes is that I've had an amazing experience. I am so grateful to be involved in it, and I'll look forward to better years ahead from what I've seen and what I'll continue to do inside this business.
Richie, that was outstanding. And I really think after 30 minutes, which is zipped past, that we will finish on that note. You have been a rock star tonight, Richie. We genuinely appreciate your time. I realize it is 6:30 where you are, 7 o'clock now probably. It's been our great delight to have you on and to speak. This is being recorded, of course, and we will get to replay this on our socials. I must warn you, though, Greg Whelan's a shark at the Gulf, so when we get to Canberra, you might have to have a couple of pennies for a hit somewhere.
He gets the wobbles. He gets the wobbles when he's partying. He can't.
Well, I haven't heard that before. Greg hasn't told me that before, but I'm glad we got you on to confirm all of that.
We did play a trifecta when we went over to New Zealand with Adam, Michael Egan, and just for the record, we played the boys in golf and darts and eight ball, and we smashed them 3-0. So that's a fact, and Richie will confirm that's the case. So yes.
No.
Well, I'm glad I posed that controversial question right at the end. It would have been a very long half hour otherwise. We will resume that in Canberra in a couple of weeks' time in July.
Absolutely.
Richie, thank you very, very much again. Genuinely appreciate the 30 minutes. I said it zipped past. You have you've been a rock star in what you do. I love the fact that contribution is huge on your list and you do a really good job of that. And again, thanks very much. And good luck to you. God bless us all. And have a good night, everybody.
Thanks, Mick. Appreciate it, mate. It's my pleasure, actually. It's my pleasure all the way. Thanks.
No.
Enjoy it. Cheers, mate.
Mind yourselves. Have a good night, everybody. Thanks very, very much. See you.
Bye.